Something that it looks to me as if she's just so finely tuned the sliced back end, she's forgotten about the top. And if you play like that, it's not easy just to keep changing it. If you don't play with both throughout your career, it becomes more and more difficult to kind of let the racket head go and just bring out the big topspin.
So three break points. Panetta does seem to have all the answers at the moment.
That wonderful two-handed backhand that he can follow it up with a lot of extra power on it, and Garbin doesn't seem to have that shot. And I feel as if she's thrown everything at the first four games, and because it, you know, Panetta's had an answer to it, all of a sudden it feels like she's just lost her intensity out here, and mentally I'm not sure she's going to be able to cope with everything. It could all go quite quickly this first set. I think she was asleep.
Just come here.
Oh, that's a beautiful point. Oh, we've seen this combination several times now, and I wonder whether it's going to put Garbin put her off coming into the net. See, there's not enough on that slice backhand, not enough depth on it, and leaves plenty of time for Panetta once again to stay very low on that backhand pass.
Yes. The set seems to be rushing away. Maybe she'll now focus on set number two. Garbin lost the second set in a rush against Vesnina yesterday, but came through in the end in the third set. Gritted her teeth. She is a fighter. But this must be a little demoralising, what's happened here.
Well, I think so, because it was such an intense first few games, wasn't it? And it really could have gone either way at the start, and all of a sudden it's just opened the floodgates and it's gone in one direction.
Panetta taking charge on the return and never relinquishing that.
And again, you can see the court positioning of the two players. Look how far behind the baseline Garbin is. And Panetta right up on it, attacking. She's just in the flow out here at the moment.
Nine in this set.
Left at the moment, isn't it? The big first serve, and she hadn't had enough of those in this first set. She's really got left at the moment, isn't it? The big first serve, and she hadn't had enough of those in this first set. Well, interesting to see Panetta try and chip that forehand return. They don't see that too often.
Afraid.
Well, it was a great move into the net there, and Nina just has a great sense of where her opponent is positioned. There's the forehand that does the damage, and she moves in. Lovely little chip backhand, very technically sound. Always waits for the right ball to move in on as well. It doesn't waste an opportunity to get up to the net.
So after 22 minutes, it's set point. Yeah, saw the gap. She's giving herself a hard time as well. Sleeve, but again she's pushing Garbin further and further back,
and just Garbin just a little bit late, particularly off that backhand. Here's the topspin which we talked about that doesn't come out very often, but just not enough on that ball. You can see there, doesn't get enough power on it.
Lapping up the slice.
Well, she just looks so comfortable out here. She's playing completely within herself, and you know that even if she was pushed a little bit more, she could find another gear to go to, whereas I feel as if Garbin just throwing everything at this, slightly out of her depth in this match.
Forlorn look there as this wonderful shot drifts over. A second set point.
Good, well,
and quite a clever return, a difficult one, but spot on.